you can be forgiven. I know how hard you try and all the obstacles you've had to overcome. I don't care what the others think. You can be weak with me. You can mess up, you can fall apart, you can be imperfect. You can let me down. I'm on your side. I'm touched by how much effort you have made and how deeply you have suffered. You don't have to prove yourself to me. I don't need you to be somebody. I can love you as you are, despite everything. I'm your best friend, always. And I'm right here.
Thank you. Our tragedy today is a general and universal physical fear, so long sustained by now that we can even bear it. There are no longer problems of the spirit. There is only the question, when will I be blown up? Because of this, the young man or woman writing today has forgotten the problems of the human heart in conflict with itself, which alone can make good writing, because only that is worth writing about, worth the agony and the sweat. He must learn them again. He must teach himself that the basis of all things is to be afraid, and teaching himself that, forget it forever, leaving no room in his workshop for anything but the old verities and truths of the heart, the old universal truths lacking which any story is ephemeral and doomed, love and honor and pity and pride and compassion and sacrifice.
such bated breath, my hand a brimming trove, I hold such spinning wheel that my ears gape. We wait and speak of nothing. I stare at your wealth as a moth would at a light. Our lies squeak like bus brakes on a boring hill. As false as Cressida, you take my hand. I look into your eyes as into a foreign vow, gathering my last words around me like photographs in a flood. I hold such bated breath, my hand a brimming trough. I hold such spinning wheel that my ears gape wide. I could take this to you later, but I take this to you now. I must act quickly, you see, before my mind invents a call. Their eyes trained on the same source, their hearts pregnant like salmon with millions of tiny hopes. Troilus, girl shy but brash-hearted, on the cusp of full living. Cressida, bright-eyed but wary, bouncing on caution's weakest knee. And when she left, gutting the house of its contents as she went, a cold emptiness replaced the full feeling, leaving him as hollow bloated as the deflating bowl of the stomach that remembers the child. Banking on the deep well of their love to bring up water, he waited 9 days for her return, his patience and the venom of noble longing. And I say yes, as true as Troilus. In privacy of heart, I shuffle vagary and trick, and the millions suck at my bowels like mice. Troilus begged for her return. Rumors of her desertion, like the cruel whisper of the winter wind, hissing through the porch teeth. 9 days of wondering how the clock could summon up enough vim to muscle through the minutes. And on the 10th day, something died. Only to hear his heart break those 10 times over. On the 10th day, something died, swelling like a tumor on the April path. 10 days of sitting still, my body buckling like the belly of an accordion. sedated in the sleep hub, and your silence at the helm of our wreckage. I sit alone in my confusion, dwarfed in not knowing why. My heart like a brass instrument, spittle heavy, wheezing out. In the small font of a footnote, I beg for the tight screw, the green light, the hungry flutter of white hands at the blackening keys, to hammer out my own truth with a sharp confession, my knuckles chiming over the launch pad like church bells, that we pierced and hunger at the keys in dreams airlifted out from where I toss alone in
jest. first triumph.